La entrada no me preocupa que no esté así tan ensayada. Está rico.
The Alliance for California Traditional Arts is a statewide organization that I co-founded, and we work to support traditions and communities. With ACTA, we've been thinking for a long time about the connection between traditional arts practice and health. As a result of our work, we're working with traditional artists in apprenticeship programs and in different community settings around the state. We've been working now with the California Endowments Building Healthy Communities in 4 sites. Boyle Heights was the first place that we initiated this work.
Well, I think we're really trying to partner with the community in order to create change as it relates to community health. We're trying to engage residents and young people in this work and really make sure that they're empowered to lead the social change agenda. And the endowment is essentially supporting those community leaders to do that.
We started talking about how people can get engaged, how residents in these different sites have a lot of strength and resilience in terms of what they know and what they do. A lot of the communities that the California Endowment is working with are really recovering from trauma.
The Building Healthy Communities Collaborative in Boyle Heights is made up of a bunch of organizations that were already doing work in Boyle Heights. So they're coming together around these specific campaigns through the Building Healthy Communities Collaborative.
At East LA Community Corporation, for the last 6 years, we've engaged community residents around accountable land use and community planning. And through that work, we've seen the value in being able to engage residents using arts. So when we had the opportunity through building communities to be able to be part of a committee that was going to be able to spread arts more in the different campaigns, we were really excited to participate.
I think it's been very valuable for us as artists to start more intentionally addressing issues of the community.
We're trying to change policies and we're trying to engage people around some of the issues that matter of improving health in our community, but it's difficult to do that. It's difficult to do that when you don't understand policy, when the information that's coming at you is incredibly dry or dull or boring or just out of grasp and not within reach. And so when you introduce an art element to it, people begin to listen.
All of us, we all took something away from it. We're walking away with something, but basically I think with pride, with our head up high, that we've accomplished something for ourselves personally, but also because of what we did, we're going to have an effect on other people and hopefully the future and justice.
El fandango nos unía, el fandango le da familia a gente, ¿no? Te da unos amigos que acaban siendo tus hermanos y entonces ese sentimiento se reproduce aquí. Gente que andaba ahí como, digamos que pateando una lata en la calle, pues de repente encuentra un grupo de gente que le da la bienvenida y empieza a tener un brillo en su vida, ¿no? Yo digo que esto es como el Son Jarocho se integra en estos movimientos de conciencia social y justicia.
They actually participated in our annual end of the year celebration, our posada, where we had over 300 people, and to have the group that worked and developed songs supporting the street vending campaign and be part of the posada, calling out our electeds and representatives of them being sure that they are working for the community and people, it was really moving to see people's expressions as they were participating. So they were able to connect to the work in a very different way.
Y este es el collage dedicado a la lucha de vendedores ambulantes. Esos versitos los hicimos en el taller. Señora Caridad, nos vemos por la noche para las quesadillas de flor y huitlacoche.
Nunca supe de algo cultural, de algo que yo... No, lo fui aprendiendo aquí porque aquí me valoricé como ser humano. Y en nuestra patria, pues muy poco nos conocen, porque somos pobres, casi no somos escuchados. Pero para mí, lo que ahora escuché y he aprendido algo que es bonito, nuestra cultura, nuestro país, y todas las personas que estuvieron lo dijeron con orgullo, y yo lo digo con orgullo.
RJPR is made possible by the Alliance for California Traditional Arts and the California Endowment. Restorative Justice Pilot Radio mobilizes youth residing within the Building a Healthy Boyle Heights community boundaries. Through research, technology, and interviews, the students set out to create awareness of restorative justice.
Taking them to the street vendors event at the Union right by MacArthur Park was a really big piece in getting them to realize that there's a lot of things happening in the outside of the community that are affecting their community. It was a process in itself to figure out what restorative justice, how you define it.
I think restorative justice is the more difficult approach to take. It's harder and it takes more work and it takes more resources, but it's necessary. And I think that no one has figured it out yet, how to do it perfectly. But what I'm really excited about is that I'm at a school with staff and with students that seem to be excited about doing it and trying to figure it out together.
This stuff works. You know, all we have to do is really empower young folks and have high expectations for them, but match that with high levels of support, and sky's the limit. So if this and that's all based on developing this program culture or this school culture, you know, that really cares and loves students and believes in them.
Restorative justice is another alternative to express yourself in a way that builds communication and understanding. And I feel it's not just that you need to use it in schools, but it's useful to bring your community together.
Everybody has everything they need to heal themselves. So one of the purpose of what we do is to give them that shift in consciousness so that they can find that for themselves and in through the form of making an altar.
When you're doing the altar, you're not only remembering, but you're connecting. It's a very spiritual and personal work because you're putting part of yourself there and then you want other people to get it, what you're trying to say.
We did a workshop called Mi Cultura Cura, and we created a booklet of herbal medicine that's helpful, and also creating altares that we commemorate not only the people who've passed in our lives, but important things that have happened to us in our lives. So the arts are indispensable to translating the work to the community that's going to be supporting it.
The basic premise is there needs to be a door that opens to everybody and everybody is welcome. And there needs to be resources to make those connections with each person.
Nuestra comunidad se merece tener espacios como esos donde no solo puedes incorporar lo que es arte, pero también puedes incorporar temas que son importantes en nuestra comunidad.
Effective organizing occurs when there's a family sense, when there's close-knit connections between people. So we've got a situation now after the workshops in which we've got three different families. Through that convivio or sharing, just community sharing, that's where ideas get generated, that's where movement starts, and that's where power is found. So I think that's what we've started.
Yes, believe it or not, we wrote this today. Dice así.
You get to sort of enliven people's spirits, and through that excitement, then you actually can allow them to focus a little bit on some of the policy work or the health reforms that need to happen here.
Boyle Heights represents an example of how a culture and a community takes hardship and struggle and transforms it into light and healing processes, mostly around art and culture.
Realmente me ha llamado la atención, es interesante, ¿no? Porque es otro método de ferias de salud. Yo le decía a ella, pues no hay medicina. no hay que vamos a hacer los exámenes. Y las personas que estamos aquí como que nos integramos más fácil, o sea, nos involucran en la actividad.
One of the things we hear a lot is about how coming together to practice traditional art is something that fosters a sense of belonging. It has a lot to do with community cohesion. People actually physically feel better when they get together and they engage in making music together, or it might be a ritual that could be related to healing. But there's a very deep and long-standing connection between traditional practices in communities and individual and collective health.